tonight, it's Boot Camp and the first installment of this weekend's double bill.
One of you is going to be this year's X Factor winner.
Best of luck. It's bad news. Don't ruin it for yourself.
The stakes have never been higher.
We have made a decision.
It's time.
I'm going home.
To face.
You suit the next.
The music.
Sing is the only thing I've got at. Sing is the only thing I want to do.
Welcome to the X Factor, where it's time to ramp up the pressure. Thousands have auditioned across the country, and the best have been brought right here to London to see if they've got what it takes to get through to the next stage of the competition. Oh, yes, it's time for boot camp. 182,000 applied for the biggest ever auditions in five cities across the country. And now just 150 acts remain in the competition. And they've all been brought across Britain here to the capital. Each of them feeling a mixture of excitement...
I can't wait.
...and fear.
I'm very, very, very nervous.
This is, like, your big moment. If you fail, then you fail.
And although they might be one step closer to the prize of a £1 million recording contract, there's still four people standing between them and their dream. The X Factor judges. Simon Cowell.
This is the point where we actually find out for the first time whether we've actually got anyone decent or not.
Danny Minogue.
If they don't do well at boot camp, it's heartbreaking.
Louis Walsh.
I know we're going to find somebody absolutely brilliant today.
And Cheryl Cole.
I'm so excited to get there and see the people that we put through.
For the contestants, this is it. They'll be singing for all four judges inside the O2 in one of Britain's most prestigious music venues. It needs to be the performance of a lifetime, and it can change their lives forever.
Welcome to Boot Camp. I'm really genuinely expecting some incredible performances today. You are going to perform one song, and we're going to decide straight after that performance whether you're staying or whether you're going.
We're looking for star quality, and you've all got one chance, one last chance to prove yourselves.
I've been here, I've stood on this stage, I know exactly how you're feeling, so good luck.
Because one of you is going to be this year's X Factor winner.
Best of luck.
So, it's time for the contestants to prepare themselves for the biggest day of their lives. And here's how it will work. Each act will head onto the stage in a row of five. And whether they're 14 or 80, soloists or groups, they're all competing in front of the judges and every one of their rivals. And after all five acts are performed, the judges will deliberate.
No way.
Before making a decision.
Step forward, please.
On who will be going to the next stage of boot camp and who will be heading home.
Front row, it's over.
The stakes have never been higher. And with the judges in place, it's time to get boot camp underway. And waiting in the wings are the first line of five to take to the stage. Joelle, Shelley, Owen, Lisa and Nathan.
Who's up first?
Hello.
And it's Joelle, yeah?
Joelle. Yeah.
Okay.
We first met Joelle in London, where she was a big hit with the judges.
I have a very, very good feeling about you.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
But can she do it again today?
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like gone. Terra Mars.
Thank you, Joelle.
Simon, I'm so sorry, but can I please finish it? If this is my only chance,
yes,
please let me finish it. All right?
You looked like a diva and you sang like a diva. Absolutely great.
Thank you very much, Louis.
You definitely made that song your own. That was absolutely fantastic. And I can't believe you're 17.
The last bit, when you started again, I really liked. Amazing.
And I'm glad you did what you just did. Glad we heard the end part.
Finished the song.
Yeah, good for you. Thanks, Joelle.
Thank you very much.
Next up, it's Shelley.
You got me begging you for mercy. Ooh, I want you to release me. You got me begging you for mercy. Ooh, I want.
While Shelley sings, schoolboy Owen from Northern Ireland is feeling the pressure.
Words can't describe, you know, the much I want that born to be a singer. That's me.
At his first audition, the judges seem to agree.
Owen, I think you've got star quality all over you.
But to win the X Factor would be an absolute dream come true. Hi.
Owen. How are you?
I'm fine. And yourselves?
Off you go.
Cos if I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're told before we get too old. Just show me our garden that's bursting into life.
You are adorable. I want to squeeze you or something. I want to roughen your cheeks up. You're absolutely gorgeous. And I think in a few years' time, you would be a superstar.
Thanks.
Really? That was good. Very good.
So, who's next?
Lisa.
Call centre worker Lisa, who recently lost an amazing 18 and a half stone, begged her way through to boot camp.
I'm just nervous. Please give me a chance. Please.
Go, yes. Okay. Go.
So, can she prove to Simon that he was right to put her through?
It's too late. It's too late. I said it's too late to apologize. It's too late.
I thought you were going to come in fighting. Well, you said to us at the first audition, we have to give you a chance.
I feel like I have improved. I do.
The truth is, you were completely and utterly out of your depth.
You're a really nice girl. The song just didn't suit you.
But we did like you when we first saw you. So we'll see.
Thank you.
Last up, it's Nathan.
Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Don't worry, baby, just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry, you don't have to worry.
So now, as the contestants wait on the stage, the judges decide who is through to the next stage of boot camp and who's going home.
Can Owen, Shelley and Joelle step forward, please? You are so going through to the next round.
Thank you so much.
Nathan. has to be a no.
I'm absolutely gutted, mate, to be honest.
Lisa, can you step forward, please? I think you know what I'm going to say, don't you? It's a no. Sorry, sweetheart.
No.
So, Lisa's dream is shattered. And as more and more contestants fall at the first hurdle, for those still waiting to perform, the pressure is getting intense.
I feel so nervous.
It's such a stressful day. It's such a stressful day, I'm telling you.
And one person who's desperate to handle the nerves is 21-year-old Austin from Essex. Austin, how are you, man?
How are you?
Nice to see you. You well?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Austin first auditioned in London, where his nerves nearly got the better of him.
My first audition, I was really, really nervous. I mean, I was shaking before I went in. I just felt like my world was going to crash down if I didn't get through this. You know, I wanted it so badly. To the end
of the road. We haven't got the best of you yet, and if that's not the best, I'm excited to see what is.
My heart is just kind of like that.
And there's one judge in particular who's desperate to impress today.
Why are you so nervous?
I'm nervous to see Simon because he's always a bit... You know, he's always a bit touch and go, isn't he? You never know whether he's going to be a bit catty or not. I want Simon to look in my eyes and know, from the moment I walk on stage, that the only time I'm really, really happy is when I'm singing. I go, some people do it because, I don't know, they want the money. Some people do it because they like, you know, the lifestyle. I do it because I love music.
And as Austin waits nervously in line for his turn to sing, he knows that his performance will be make or break.
This could potentially change everything I'm doing. I've just got to prove to these people in front of me that I want it more than anybody else in the whole competition. Hello.
But sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. Yeah. And I'm thinking to myself, what you doing? In my head, I paint a picture. But then, since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over? Stop being a fool and me. Oh, won't you come on over my way? Hey, send by the rain.
Austin, you know, you've got a lot of soul. I love the fact that you own the stage, you've got everybody on their feet, you've got a lot of soul, and you're very confident. I liked it.
Thanks, Lou. Cheers.
You actually are a natural born performer and you've got a gift.
Thank you very much.
You own that stage.
I actually wanted to get up and dance, and I'm glad they loved you as much as I did. Fantastic.
Austin. What you just did up there was magic, I have to tell you. It really was. Good for you.
And now everyone on stage has sung, it's up to the judges to decide who will make it to the next stage of boot camp and who will be heading home.
We've made a decision. Imani, exclusive. Austin. Step forward, please. You are through to the next round.
That was amazing.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
I'm absolutely in love with what I do, and I just don't want anyone to take it away from me.
Still to come.
You're going home.
Sure I can win.
Don't ruin it for yourself.
Welcome back to the X Factor Bootcamp here at the O2. The remaining contestants are hoping and praying they've got what it takes to move one step closer to their ultimate dream. And to do that, each act will be singing their hearts out on stage in front of the X Factor judges and their fellow contestants. And the next row of five are desperate to impress.
Right, who are we going to start with?
Carla, Edney.
I really want to do this, and I can't let the nerves get the better of me.
Off you go.
The first time ever I saw your face.
Gorgeous voice, Carla, but you need to let loose a little bit more.
Next to perform is this year's oldest contestant, 80-year-old Cyril, who we met in London. Now, the judges absolutely loved you last time, Cyril.
Hey, good looking, how about cooking something up with me?
Yeah. I thought you were fantastic.
Thank you.
So, can Cyril impress the judges again?
Whenever you're
ready. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, I love you.
You know, you're old-fashioned and you're great. I like you.
Thank you.
So, let me ask you a question, and please give me an honest answer.
Yes.
Are you doing this because you think you can win, or are you doing it for the chicks?
I'm doing it because I'm sure I can win. I have one foot in, and the next foot is nearly there.
Right, well... OK.
Next up, it's 14-year-old Christina.
You come on over, Valerie.
Followed by single dad Daniel, who made a big impact at his audition.
Why are you here today?
It's kind of a wish of my wife. And unfortunately, last year, just after giving birth to my gorgeous little baby girl, my wife passed away. I realised that life is too short. I decided this year, let's go for it, you know, and just at least I can say I'll try.
I can see why your wife wanted you to audition. I think she'd be very proud.
Okay.
The first time ever I saw your face, I thought the sun rose in your eyes.
I loved you the first time I saw you. Thought that was a brilliant song choice.
My problem is that at the end of the day, we're looking for someone who's going to sell records. And I've heard people like you in hotel bars before.
I like him, Simon. I really like him.
Would you buy his record?
Thank you very much, thank you.
Last up, it's 19-year-old Bianca.
OK, off you go.
You got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you release me? You got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you release me?
OK, thank you. All right, guys.
OK.
As the judges decide their fate, the contestants now have an anxious wait.
I just think it would make such a difference after having such a bad couple of years. You know, this is the turnaround. This is, we're now on the uphill slope.
I want it more than anything else. At my age, this is my last big chance.
This means everything to me today. Absolutely everything. I have to get through. I have to.
Carla? Bianca. Christina, step forward, please. Back row. Congratulations.
I am 80 years old and I'm still going. I'm still going strong. I got another 10 years.
I can't put words to it. It's just, it's amazing. It's great. Okay, no. I've lost the words.
Girls, it's a no.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
They're obviously looking for something, and if you're not it, you're not it.
Every act that made it through to boot camp impressed the judges in their first audition, but not many people wowed them like best friends JLS.
And I was caught up. Physical attraction.
I love you. I love you. You just made this competition very, very exciting.
Even now, I can't believe we got the comments that we did, you know. Yeah. It was absolutely fantastic.
And now they've made it to boot camp, the pressure is on to impress once more.
We've been rehearsing vigorously every single day. We just see each other every day. We might as well live in a house together. This competition means the world to us. We need to win this.
Got everything on that stage. You remind me of one of the early Motown groups. You know, guys, you've got it all.
Thank you, Louie.
Thank you, Louie.
You're way up there now. We are expecting so much from you. So there's a lot of pressure.
Thank you very much.
We can handle it.
Guys, here's my problem. I didn't hear one great vocal throughout that whole performance. And that's something you absolutely have to figure out.
Thank you, Simon.
And as the judges deliberate, all JLS can do is hope they've done enough.
We've decided that we're going to see you again.
So, JLS make it to the second stage of boot camp. And as the day goes on, they're not the only ones celebrating.
My models got me on my knees. I'm begging you, please, stop playing games.
Fantastic voice.
Thanks very much.
You're through to the next round.
Babe, you're not lost.
Very convincing, very professional. And you're only 14.
Congratulations.
I like the audition, I like the old Motown song.
We've all decided we'd like to see you again.
Thank you so much!
The first time ever I saw your face.
I think you don't realise how good you are. We've decided that we'll see you again.
Oh,
thank you.
So, as the judges take a break, they're feeling happy about what they've seen.
It's been good, hasn't it?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's absolutely fantastic.
But nervously waiting for her turn is Laura, who they first met in Manchester when she was suffering from a sore throat.
Just warning, I've been poorly, so if it's not the best it can be, then ask me another one and I'll
Laura's
sing a jazz
fine.
Song.
Off you go.
You are the one who makes me feel so
okay, I'm going to stop before you kill yourself. Just wish you'd been healthy.
Despite her illness, Laura got four yeses.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Get healthy. Off you go.
I think I'm just going to go in, be me, and just keep praying that I do my best, and hopefully it'll happen.
So, Laura, are you nervous?
I'm always nervous.
What song are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing The First Time Ever I Saw Your Face. First time ever I lay with you, I felt your heart so close to mine. And I knew I'd yours. It would fill the earth. The first time ever I saw your face, your face, your face, your face.
One of the best singers we've had today. I think you've got potentially great, great career.
Yeah, I couldn't take my eyes off you. I was getting goosebumps at times. You blew me away.
I don't think you're aware of how good you are. You also made it your version.
Yeah.
Okay, guys.
So the decision is?
You're through.
No! No!
I'm checking so
hard. Come on, though, I was never in any doubt, was it?
I was so nervous. As soon as I started, I thought, thank God, I've had the opportunity to sing in front of him again and my voice is back. And it means everything. The captain.
Still to come.
I have got singers like that coming out of my ears.
Louis, man, you're a hero!
Welcome back to the X Factor Bootcamp, where for the first time, the boys, the girls, the groups, and the solo artists are all performing under one roof on one stage. Now, shoulder to shoulder they may be, but who's going to be left standing at the end of the day?
Why do you want to go and put stars in their eyes?
Everyone here has worked hard to make themselves look their best for their audition, but none more so than our next act. We first met 19-year-old Pontins Bluecoat Scott when he auditioned in Manchester.
And you never walk alone.
He got a yes, despite some reservations.
I think you need to update your image a bit.
Yeah.
We need to drag you into 2008.
And having taken the judges' advice, it's an all-new Scott that's arrived at boot camp. Since we saw you last, tell me what's happened with you.
Well, I've completely changed. I've shaved all my hair off, got a brand new wardrobe, because the judges told me to basically modern up because I was old-fashioned.
And what's happened since your audition in terms of your job and stuff?
Well, I actually had to quit my job to come to boot camp.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It come to a point where it came to a choice with Pontins or the X Factor, and for me, I had to look at what was going to be best for me in the long run, hopefully.
I can't believe it's over. I watched the whole thing fall, and I never saw the writing that was on the wall. If I'd only knew the days were slipping past, and that the good things never last, and that you were crying. Ooh. Summer turned to winter, and the snow it turned to rain, and the rain turned into tears upon your face.
Thank you, Scott. That's love.
You look a lot different to the first time we saw you.
You told me to change my style, so here I am, and I hope you like it.
You look better for it, and you actually sang better than the first time around.
Thank you.
Image is great. I think that song needed more personality, but I like your voice.
Scott, I thought potentially you were better than that, but what you've just shown me then is you're not prepared to take risks.
Okay. As the judges deliberate, Scott waits anxiously to hear his fate.
Scott, can you step forward, please? Unfortunately, you're going to have to do this all over again. Listen to what I said.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
How you doing?
speechless is probably the word at the minute. Oh, I've got it. Just got to prepare myself for the next stage now. Thank you very much, David.
So it's a yes for Scott. And leading the next row of five to sing for the judges, or another act who are told to change their image at the last audition.
Right, you are...
Adante.
And we saw you in...
Cardiff.
The last audition.
Oh.
Adele.
Not the last audition. Yeah, the last audition didn't go... It went well, because we got through to book camp, but the comments.
The outfits, the attitude, the performance. The problem is that everything kind of is a bit cheap.
Cheap? £50 shows? Cheap.
Terrible.
I thought you said chic, so I was going, oh, thanks a lot, Simon. I really appreciate it.
So can Adante now win Simon over?
You got me begging you for mercy.
Yeah, yeah.
Why won't you release me?
Yeah, yeah. You've got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you release me?
Job on the song. I enjoyed it.
Oh, Louis, man, you're a hero! A hero, I call you!
Sure,
I much prefer the image. I think you two look far better than the first audition.
Oh. I really liked you. Oh,
I yeah. Damn you! Fantastic, thanks.
We can't compare you to anyone else around at the moment because you're not like a proper group. Your appeal is you're a couple of normal girls who I think actually the public may like. But you're not very good singers, and I can't actually take the two of you that seriously.
Oh, Simon, we are trying. We're getting better and better.
No, I think you're both a couple of tryers.
Before Adante find out the judge's decision, they must wait. Whilst Trevor...
And we'll get lost together until the light comes pouring through.
Jeffrey.
Summer turned to winter, and the snow it turned to rain.
Let's Sasha.
Keep it friendly. You have to play fair.
And Dwayne get the chance in the spotlight.
We can rule the world.
Okay.
So once again, the judges must decide who's going through to the next round and who's going home.
We've made a decision. Sasha, can you please come forward?
and Dwayne. Based on everything we've heard, we've decided that you're going home.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So it's a no for Sasha and Dwayne, which leads to Dante, Trevor, and Jeffrey.
Please step forward. Based on the performance today, we've decided that you're going to come back and join us.
Dante, Trevor, and Jeffrey are through to the next stage, and they're not alone.
Tell me that you're sorry, didn't think I'd turn around and say, hey, that it's too late to apologize.
Made it through.
You got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you release me? I said, release.
Next round.
It means so much to get from this far. It really counts. But I'm gonna fight all the way till the end. Definitely.
If I just lay here, would you lie with me?
Congratulations.
Oh man, it's a bit of
best feeling in the world.
When I'm at college, half the day I just spend daydreaming about being on stage and making it big and everything instead of being there, and I just, that's all I want, that's all I ever dream of.
But if I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?
I was excited to see you again and you haven't let me down.
I think you're very good, but I don't think we've heard the best of you yet.
If I lay here,
oh, I'm going, oh my God.
If I just lay here,
yeah. Would you lie away?
I'm so excited.
Well done.
We are halfway through it, and I have to say, Bootcamp is looking pretty good. Happy judges and lots of yeses. But for the contestants left waiting to audition, there's the added pressure of watching on whilst others succeed, which doesn't make things easy.
Watching the other contestants has been a very daunting experience, actually.
It's like sudden death this year.
You feel the atmosphere in the room and it's really like...
And one person who's feeling that pressure in particular is 19-year-old Alexandra. Alexandra has been here before. She got to Louis Judge's home 3 years ago. But she failed to progress to the live finals.
You're going home.
Three years on, and she's back and finding the competition harder than ever.
I'm more nervous than I was 3 years ago, man. This time, it's just worse.
The girls seem really strong, I feel like it's the strongest I've ever seen X Factor with girls-wise, and that is my category, and that's what's making me even more scared. I feel like I stand no chance. It's not the same as it was 3 years ago. Talent grows in this world, and the show has grown.
And as Alexandra takes to the stage, the strain is overwhelming.
I want to do well. I really want to make it further than I did last time, but I just don't feel it's going to happen this year, and I really want it to. So
I felt your heart so close to mine, and I knew
would feel the unknown. Yeah, it will last till the end of time, my love. And the first time ever I saw
Alexander, that was absolutely great. Faultless, faultless audition. I think you've improved incredible.
Thank you.
My body was covered in head to toes with goosebumps. You were born to do this.
Thank you.
It is insane what we have seen today. And you're one of the really good ones.
Thank you very much.
Love
Thank
her.
You.
You are incredibly mature. Fantastic potential. And you know what's really exciting? We still haven't heard the best of you yet.
Oh, God.
Okay.
So, now Alexandra has sung, it's decision time.
You're through to the next round. Congratulations.
Oh, my God, I'm shaking.
Oh. Still to come.
Either you've got it at this point, or you haven't.
It's so easy for you to sit there.
Welcome back to The X Factor, where boot camp is in full flow. And already it's been a day of highs and lows, as many saw their dream come to an end. And now it's time for the next five acts to do their thing.
Just tell me who you are again.
Bad Lashes. In control.
When Bad Lashes first auditioned, Louis wasn't that keen.
It's like four hairdressers trying to be a girl band.
Louis.
So, can they win him over this time?
What are you going to sing?
Chasing Cars by Snow Patrol.
Great. Off you go.
If I lay
girls, much improved.
You don't, oh, thank you!
You don't even look like the same girls.
No, hairdressers, we not hairdressers.
We don't look like hair.
You don't look like four hairdressers. No, you, I think you've improved an awful lot.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. That was a massive improvement, I've got to tell you. Do we have four of the best singers in this competition? I'm not sure. But there is
something
potential
something.
Here.
Yeah, thank you.
We can rock
thank
it.
You. Thank you.
Potential.
Thank you very much.
Hi, Sharon.
Next up is Shirley, who had a confession for Louis at her first audition.
Why have you got a rose?
I've got it for Louis.
Do you like him?
Yeah, I do. I love you, Louis.
Thank you very much, Shirley. Thank you very much.
What are you going to sing today?
I'm singing Britney Spears, Not Yet a Girl, Not Yet a Woman.
Is that because Louis likes Britney?
No, it's because I feel that she's got a bit of bad press at the moment.
OK, whenever you're ready.
I'm no one again.
That's fine. That's love.
You know, Shirley, I think Brittany would have liked that.
Thank you very much, Louis.
But before Bad Lasses and Shirley find out if they're through to the next round, they have to wait while Marlon... Ruth.
And we'll get lost together until the light comes pouring through.
Maybe we just should have heard more of your Spanish side, maybe, today.
And Nicole all sing.
Why don't you come on over, Van O'Brien?
Okay.
So, once again, it's decision time.
OK, could Ruth and Nicole step forward, please? Girls, you're through to the next round. Shirley and Marlon, please. Shirley, you have the likability, don't you?
Yeah, I like to think so.
No, people like you. And we took that into account. Decision is... I'm afraid it's bad news. It's over. See you later.
It's a yes for Ruth and Nicole and a no for Shirley and Marlon, which just leaves Bad Lasses.
Girls, step forward. Okay. We've made a decision. Girls. Good news. Go and practice.
We are. It's one step closer and we're just going to work on.
Yeah.
So, for Bad Lasses, all the hard work was worthwhile. And hoping that his years of plugging away will finally pay off is Ricky, who we first met in Glasgow.
I've done so many auditions and I never actually make it. Have you ever wanted something so much that every time you fought to get it, you actually can't get it?
And now Ricky wants to use this opportunity to impress the two people who think he needs to give up on his dream.
I'm here to prove to my mum and dad that I can do this. They've seen me fall so much, I think that they think that I should just end it.
Are they of the ilk that you've got to start doing a proper job now?
I just think I should live in reality, and this is my reality, though. This is my only chance, so there's no holding back.
OK, welcome. Let's have the first contestant, please.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good.
I'm Ricky. I'm from Glasgow.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing first time, and I'm sure it's not going to be the last time you'll hear it either.
It's OK. OK, off you go.
Ooh, the first time ever I saw your face, I felt the soul.
Yeah, it was a good audition. You came in well prepared. Well
done. Brilliant.
I enjoyed it. Loved the vocals.
Thank you.
There was a couple of flat notes in there.
Yeah, yeah, I know that.
But I like the fact that you made it your own, and you really have the likability factor, actually.
Ricky, I love the performance, but I actually think that you can do much more than that.
I'm just a wee bit nervous.
Well, I have to say, you know, at this stage in the competition, I don't get the whole nerves thing. Either you've got it at this point, or you haven't.
Yeah, no.
Because let me tell you, it's a damn sight more nerve-wracking singing in the live shows.
It is nerve-wracking to stand up there, very nerve-wracking.
But
it's nerve-wracking,
nerve-wracking
enough to come into the
first. Standing at the live shows.
So while the rest of the contestants sing, Ricky is left waiting to see if he'll get the break he longs for.
It just means so much to me. I just want this so much. I just want to prove to other people as well that I can do this.
So the judges deliberate, But has Ricky done enough to make his parents believe in him once again?
Ricky, Katie, Michelle, Mally, Rachel, step forward. Guys, you're all going through to the next round.
Absolutely over the moon that I've been put through. It is one step closer to actually prove to my mum and dad that this is what I'm here to do.
So Ricky and the other lucky acts impress the judges and go flying through to the next stage. And although the day's almost over, there's still plenty of people getting a yes from the judges.
Under my umbrella, Ella, Ella, under my umbrella.
The improvement from when I first saw you to now is huge.
Yeah. See you next round!
Won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie?
You are one hell of a yummy mummy, aren't you?
We're gonna see you again.
Cause you are not alone, and I am there with you, and we'll get lost together.
We'd like to give you another chance.
We're gonna be seeing you again.
Did you? And we'll get lost together.
I think you sang that song beautifully.
You got another shot.
And as the day draws to a close, 26-year-old Rachel is hoping she'll also impress the panel. At her first audition, Rachel wowed the judges.
I told you I was trouble, and you know that I'm no good.
I absolutely love you.
Thank you.
Things haven't always gone so well for Rachel, and as the judges found out in her first audition, problems with drugs led to a spell in prison, and her three children being taken into care. Having now turned her life around, Rachel is looking for a better future for her and her children.
All the things you've been through and the person you were before now, it must be nice for you to look back at that person and go, I'm not that person anymore. I don't want to do those things anymore. This is what I want to do now. And that motivates you, I guess.
Yeah, right? It does. This really, really is like a second chance to me, and I'm so grateful for it. I do feel that the judges have thrown me a lifeline. I just want to just keep achieving my dream. I just want to keep moving forward.
We'll do it all, everything on our own.
Sorry, it's too fast.
Contestants that I went home and spoke to my family about. I've thought about you ever since. I couldn't wait to see you again today. And you've got a raw talent, you've got an unbelievable voice, and I just want that buzz you came into the audition with back. I want that energy and that confidence back, because you are unbelievable.
I think you gained a lot of fans during that performance just then.
Rachel, you are potentially one of the best singers I've heard in this country for maybe 10 years. I think you're that good. But, that performance will not work on this show. What you started to do was ruin the song. And this is the most unforgiving competition on TV. You get it wrong once, you can go.
Well, I won't be making that mistake.
No, Rachel, you've got to choose a song, you have to nail the arrangement, and you have to stick with it.
Can I defend myself there? Can I defend myself here? Because for everyone who stands up here, yeah, it's so easy for you to sit there. Like, from I got through, I've practiced, and I know I nailed the song.
Rachel, I don't need you telling me what I should or shouldn't
I'm
be
not,
saying.
But you
Rachel,
know,
Rachel. Don't ruin it for yourself here.
I'm not gonna, but I'm telling
no,
you,
but
I have, and nerves
no.
did get the better
Rachel,
of me. That's all I'm trying
to
say.
Rachel, you are beginning to ruin it for yourself. I understand the pressure you're all under, so don't use that as an excuse, OK? I'm saying it for your own good. You cocked up the arrangement, and I don't want to see you do it again. One of us has to work with you, but you have to listen. We're trying to help you.
Sorry.
So, it's time to decide who will stay and who will go. And along with everyone else, Rachel waits for a decision from the judges.
OK. Rachel, could you step forward? Back row. You're through to the next round. Rachel. So are you.
As she comes off the stage, reality hits, and Rachel realises how close she was to being out of the competition.
And singing is the only thing I want to do. Just feel it in your soul, and I have to do it. To know that you want something so bad and you nearly lost it, I'll never be so arrogant again in my life. It's so stupid, man.
She's got this problem, Rachel, which is when she's got an opportunity, she blows it, and it's like a defence mechanism, and she doesn't trust people. And she's got to sort that out, because in terms of raw talent, she's one of the best singers we've ever had on this competition.
Grumpy. Yeah. You are.
I have some bad news.
Welcome back to the X Factor Bootcamp here at the O2. So far, it's been an unforgettable day full of emotion. All of the contestants have now performed, and the judges have given their verdict. But the drama of the day isn't over yet, because the judges have unexpectedly gathered together the contestants who got a yes at the first stage of boot camp. The judges have called everyone onto the stage. We're not entirely sure what's going on, but they said they want to speak to them.
Let's start with the good news. One of you, standing on this stage right now, is going to win the X Factor. However, I have some bad news. In the next hour, roughly one third of you are going to leave the competition. We are going to make some decisions and we'll be seeing you in about an hour's time.
The bomb that Simon and the other judges have just dropped has left the contestants shell-shocked.
Everybody is absolutely devastated.
It's like we've auditioned today and you get all that joy and excitement. You think, wow, you know, we can relax. And now they throw this at us.
Just absolutely shocked. Completely shocked.
90 acts have got through day one of boot camp and brought into this room. They know that a third of them are going home in 1 hour. The tension in here is unbearable. So with only 50 places available on the second day of boot camp, the judges have got some tough decisions to make.
You ready?
Let's do it, guys.
Who are our front runners in this area? Seriously.
Her.
I like him.
If I had a choice of signing him or her, I'd sign her.
But she can't sing.
I don't like him.
No, can't stand
it. It's just completely out of my hands now.
Okay, this is where it gets tough.
This girl should go.
Yeah. She just didn't deliver today.
To sit here and have to wait on a decision for a whole hour is just, I can't even describe it. It's just heart-wrenching right now.
This is a great category.
This girl is the one to beat, right?
Yeah.
Love this girl.
And the other one, yeah.
Absolutely no idea if they're going to keep me or not. I just thought they just see the best in me and that they do think there is potential.
These guys are at the top.
Yeah.
They sang really well. Maybe.
Hopefully we've done good enough to be through.
You know, no one here feels safe.
Well, let's just agree on one we
and
hate.
Don't.
Okay.
Out.
We thought we'd have at least, like, one last time to prove ourselves, but it doesn't look like there's going to be that last chance.
I think there's so much more to show.
He is a fantastic singer. This one can't sing.
I can't think of nothing more than I'm going home in an hour's time.
What about him? Because he can't sing.
I disagree.
No, I think he can.
I think highly of myself, innit? Like, I'm not one of those people who's going to doubt myself. I do think I'm going to be all right, but it's not up to me. It's up to the judges, innit?
There's three of us saying this one. Yeah. You're being stubborn, grumpy. Yeah.
No, I'm not.
You are.
I'm not.
You are.
No more arguing. That's it. Okay, well, let's go and get them into their rooms.
Yeah. Scott Bruton, Ricky Loney.
So, with the decisions made, each act's name is called out and they head off to await their fate in one of three rooms. Each room now faces an agonising wait and everybody's nerves are starting to show.
It's all nerve-wracking.
It's scary. It really is.
So here we go, the moment of truth. The judges are about to enter a very nervous room one and tell them whether they're going home or they're going through. So it's the moment of truth for Rachel, JLS, Laura, and everyone in room one.
The torture is nearly over.
See how much you've bonded with each other and you've had a blast, but I know you're desperate to know the answer.
What we've tried to do this year, we've tried to find somebody different. And the decision which we came to after a lot of deliberation is... it's a yes. Yeah!
That's a happy room. Expect it or not?
I don't know what I expected. It was
just... Well done,
good job, buddy. So, room one are left on cloud nine, but two rooms still await their fate, and the tension is growing.
yeah, we don't really know whether we're getting through or not, but we got to try and stay positive.
We're so hard for it. I just don't want to do it.
So will it be the news that Kirsty, Ryan, Pure Elements and everyone else in Room 2 are hoping for?
It's my first boot camp, so I didn't really know what to expect, but I've been blown over by the amount of talent that's been up there on that stage.
We spent an awful long time working out who we wanted to make or have a chance of making the finals. And the decision we've made is... it's bad news. Sorry.
Too many people
at home. The contestants in Room 3 have heard the commotion coming from the other two rooms and hopes are fading.
It could be that I'm in the no room and I'm going home and this is over.
I'm just scared to death. I just think it's bad news.
So, Alan, Ruth and Bad Lashes believe it might all be over.
So, Room 3, you're about to get the verdict. Any second now.
This is the highest standard it has ever, ever been. This year's been incredible. So everybody's been really, really good.
We only have roughly 50 places left. So you can imagine it's been a tough decision. And all of you can walk away, whatever happens, with your heads held high on this. Yeah? The decision we made... it's good news.
It's the definition of happiness.
I'm dying.
Oh, that's some hug you got on your buddy. Congratulations.
Take a look at me.
Celebrations all round for the 50 acts going through. So that is it for stage one of Bootcamp. Join us tomorrow night for stage two. Twice as tough, twice as intense, and twice as heartbreaking. We'll see you then.
Tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, the X Factor continues with day two of Bootcamp. More drama.
Just falling apart here.
Doing this for my kids, for my family.
More emotion.
Please don't take my dream away from me.
I want it. I need it. And there is nothing else.
More decisions.
I don't get the fact you don't get it.
I don't get the fact that you do.
We have made a decision.
We're going home.
It's good news.
And the judges find out which category they'll be mentoring for the rest of the competition.